Why do young working class people commit crime? Part 2. In part 1, we looked at why young working class people, young men in particular, commit crime. We looked at the different strain theories that are based on Merton's original theory. This concluded that all subcultures are committed to money success. In this way, subcultures are seen as a reaction by male working class lads' inability to obtain this goal. Other sociologists utilize these concepts but do not share such functionalist assumptions. Focal concerns and Walter Miller. Miller doesn't see the deviant behavior happening due to the inability of the lower class groups to achieve success, but rather, Miller explains crime in terms of the existence of a distinctive lower class subculture. This social class has for centuries possessed their own culture and traditions, which are fundamentally different from those in the higher classes. Miller suggests working class youth subculture has developed a series of focal concerns which give meaning to their life outside of work. Miller's list 6 focal concerns. Smartness, to outwit, dupe or take others. Subgroups that use these techniques include the hustler, conman, the pimp and pickpocket. Toughness, heightened form of masculinity, and they find expression in courage in the face of physical threat and a rejection of weakness. This can result in assault and battery as the group attempt to maintain their reputation. Excitement, searching for thrills. Subgroups can find these in gambling, sexual adventures and booze, which can be gained by a night out on the town. Fate. The subgroup believes in fatalism, que sera sera, whatever will be, that little can be done about their lives. Trouble. Young working class men accept that their lives will involve violence and that they will not run away from fights. Autonomy. The desire for personal respect within their immediate subcultural groups. A general resentment of middle-class authority figures who dominate their working life leads to their desire to exercise some form of freedom in areas where some control and power is possible. David Matzer. In his book Delinquency and Drift and British Studies, 1964, the American interactionist sociologist Matzer argues that the delinquents are similar to everyone else in their values and voice similar feelings of outrage about crime in general as a majority of society. Matzer argues that we hold two levels of values or subterranean values. One, conventional values, are the roles of a father and occupation. Two, subterranean values, values of sexuality, greed and aggressiveness. These are generally controlled, but we all hold them and we all do them. Matzer therefore suggests that delinquents are just more likely than most of us to behave according to subterranean values in inappropriate situations. Matzer suggests that delinquents justify their own crimes as exceptions to the rule. They convince themselves that the law does not apply to them on a particular occasion. Deviance becomes possible when they use techniques of neutralization. Matzer's 5 justifications of neutralization. Denial of responsibility. I was drunk. It was my upbringing. It's the area. Denial of the victim. The crime is wrong, but the victim deserved it. For example, I hate white people. I hate black people. Denial of injury. The victim will not be harmed by the crime committed. They can afford it. Condemnation of condemns. The delinquents argue that the accusers are no different from themselves. I was drink driving, but so does everyone else. No different from themselves. I was drink driving, but so does everyone. Appeal to higher loyalties. The delinquent claims that they had to do it because of a moral stand, such as, I'm not a snitch. Matzer criticized subcultural theories. Only a small minority of youth become delinquents. When confronted to explain their delinquency, young individuals rarely make reference to membership of subcultures, for example, a gang. Most young working class people experience what Cohen calls status frustration, but they don't necessarily become deviant. Particularly agents of social control, such as the police, may increase deviant behavior by stereotyping working class men. Evaluation. Miller seems to be saying that the involvement in lower class culture is so deep and exclusive that contact with agents of middle class dominated institutions, especially schools, have no impact. Miller seems to be implying that working class culture is problematic and inferior to middle class culture. Miller's theory is similar to the underclass theory of Charles Murray. Taylor, Walton and Young raise doubts about Matz's view that those who are using the technique of neutralization are never challenging the dominant values in society. Summary. Miller argues that working class youth subculture has created a series of focal concerns which helps to provide meaning in their lives. For example, a desire for excitement or an increased sense of masculinity. Miller sees delinquency as the consequence of normal working class values. This is due to socialization for many generations. Matza claimed that delinquents are similar to everyone else in their values and voice similar feelings of outrage about crime in general as the majority of society.